you guys understand by the term gender equality?
Keeping the levels of female and male at the same level.
Personally, I think gender equality is like where girls are treated the same way as boys. Like no discrimination, no favoring one side over the other. So that's gender equality.
So equal opportunities for all. You think the opposite gender is favored a lot more than yours?
To me, I take girls as they are highly favored in Uganda. If you had to check like in A level, like after, like for the UCA, for the results, eh? Girls are highly favored. For them, they are given more points. They are given some extra point, which I believe it's unfair. Because what I know, what a man can do, a woman can do so. So we are equal.
You think it should be scrapped off, that extra point. Do you agree?
I don't agree.
Why?
Because you find that mostly girls, they meet a lot of difficulties when they are studying more than boys.
Like what kind of difficulties?
Okay, let me give an example of the way girls like coupling in schools.
Uh-huh.
It really affects girls more than boys.
How? Huh?
This thing of coupling, a boy may come and tell you, I love you, those things. You can take it to the heart when the boy is actually playing
you.
I would like to advise my sisters out there. Please, don't just depend on free things. Yeah. Just work for yourself. I know you can be better. Because there are women who are president, there are men who are president.
Yes.
There are this one women who are pastors, again there are men who are pastors. Please just work on your own and achieve what you have done by yourself, not free stuff.
And that is what this sustainable goal is all about. Gender equality, where we are working to have women as more contributors than dependents. Okay? Not because, oh, I'm a female, then I am entitled to free points. Or because I'm a female, I should not work as hard as men do.
In most schools, I have this feeling that boys are more favored. Because you can come to a school and find a boy is the president. Why not a girl? We need to have gender equality. So if a boy can be a president, it means a girl can be a president of the school.
Like the current speaker, Honorable Rebecca Kadaga. As you can see, she took that post because she was capable, and there was also a man who could also take up that post. That shows that all of us, we are equal. We are equal. It's only that some people, like, they despise themselves.
Men are a lot more focused. What drives them is success, money, because that's what I think you guys think. To have money makes you important. Okay, so that is what drives you. So girls, please, ladies, we are fighting for gender equality. So if you want to be equal, you have to step up to the plate.
I'm not what happened to me. I am what I choose to become. Mirungu Lukman Jr. from 4Bs. I'm a cheating and you're watching Urban TV.
Girls, what problems do girls face that make them less more able to succeed than boys?
In some schools, they have this issue of teacher-girl relationship, where a teacher can mean to torture you, to torment you, like in case, you know, you'll be like, Shadia, I want you to date me this and this, and in case you refuse, trust me, however much you pass GP, he'll keep giving you no point, so it affects your performance. Mm. So if this one extra point is given, let's just imagine maybe that teacher is also marking a tab. If this one extra point is given, it can help you, you know, like, you know, join the university, not waste all your effort for nothing.
If, say for instance, that happened, you need to talk to somebody that is going to help you, because you do not have to be, you can't allow for yourself to be tormented. How do you think the youth can empower themselves?
If someone has a dream, when you have a dream and you have, like, you're having something that you're aiming at, you can't be distracted by anything. Like for instance, here at school, like if you came home like from home and had a dream that, like, in this term I'm aiming at getting above 15 points, However challenges you may face, you'll still stick to your goal.
Yeah.
You'll still work hard to achieve it. Yeah, I believe having a dream is the best thing.
You have to set targets. Like, you have to have targets in life. You'll be like, Shadia, I have to do this and this. That's when you'll be able to accomplish it. It will empower you to do something with your life. But if you're this kind of chick or dude who doesn't care, trust me, you'll not make meaning to the world.
The best way you can use is to interact with people, making more friends who advise you, we are doing this, we have to do this, this is the right way, you are doing the bad thing, you are moving on the wrong side, and help you focus more or advise you on what you can do better.
For you to own yourself and learn to be yourself.
Yeah.
Just make sure you monitor your life. I know everyone who's outside there, you know your problem. and you can get possible solution through every kind of way. Like you can consult your friends, you can consult teachers, just own your life, be yourself, and don't mind what other people say about you. Just be yourself and make sure you don't have any problem.
Thank you. And like they said, the best form of empowerment in a nutshell is to be knowledgeable. Find the information you need to solve whatever problem you have. Okay, if you have a problem, don't just sit on it. Find a solution. Consult your peers, like she said. You know, set targets, like he said. Have a dream, like she said. Find the solution, and nothing will stop you. Nothing is impossible. So don't forget to follow us on our social media handles. That is Ajitin on Facebook and Ajitin on Instagram.
Hi Ajitin. We are Mr. and Mrs. Cleo Spamtura, and we are happy mentors of Ajitin. A woman who takes initiative and adds value not only to herself, but also to society. A woman of substance leaves a mark wherever they go. They are recognized and they do not fear to take very important decisions. This is the woman we are talking about.
The man who respects people around him, and not just respecting women or men, but all the people around him. A man who's a leader, and for me, leadership is not about positions. Leadership is about changing lives. A man who brings hope to the hopeless, who brings hope to all those around him, and a man who leaves a mark in those that they get to encounter, not just in their family, but around them, the poor and the whole society.